Okay, we will now see our candidates in their formal wear presentation, unless I'm told otherwise here, which makes up 20% of the judging. The judges are looking for grace, grooming, poise, eye contact, and carriage in the typical Filipino formal attire, as well as appearance, coordination, and composure. They were given the following question. Being the 40th anniversary, what is your best memory of Philippine weekend and why? And we start tonight with Mr. Candidate, Christopher Patricio. Christopher's best memory of Philippine weekend was when he got to perform as a Philippine weekend cultural dancer under the direction and choreography of United Filipino Organization. For the many that know him, they know Christopher is shy and rarely goes out of his comfort zone. But this particular summer, much like tonight, he set his comfortability aside and performed tonight the Sayaw Sabako with performers who were much older than him. Despite his nervousness, he was one of the main dancers who had to balance himself and his partner on the benches that were propped up very high off the ground. He says it was really scary, but very exhilarating, and he considers this moment an accomplishment because he got over his fear of performing in front of big crowds. And tonight, he's putting his fear aside again as he competes in the Mr. and Miss Philippine Weekend pageant and will be able to add yet another memory to Philippine Weekend. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Christopher Patricio. Being the 40th year, EJ's favorite memory of Philippine weekend was going to the park with his family, being able to watch the different performances, and then seeing everyone from all over California come and enjoy his Filipino culture. He also loved being a part of some of the dance performances, and like we all do, eating all that great food that they have at the Philippine Festival. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. EJ Bunad. Candidate number three is Mr. Mark Ublera. In the 40 years of Philippine Weekend festivities, Mark's favorite memory was dancing with Studio 661's senior crew for last week's exhibition as part of the dance competition. Along with hanging out with friends and family, it was his first time performing on the Philippine Weekend stage. And he remembers dressing up for the performance in pants and a button-up. Since the stage was black and carpeted, the heat was intensified. After the first move, Mark pushed through. This is his favorite memory because it was a humbling experience getting to share his love of dance with his studio family and the audience of Philippine Weekend. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Mark Ublera. And candidate Anthony's favorite memory of Philippine weekend was participating in the dance competition with his crew, Boys in Style. Although the nights of practice seemed endless, the dedication and love for dancing pulled him through. It was worth the memories made both during practice and after, during the midnight burger run. The end result was an explosive dance routine that managed to impress friends, family, and the older generations of Boys in Style. The dance competition will certainly be something Anthony will be looking forward to every summer. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Anthony Yabag. Now on to our Miss Candidates. Candidate number one is Miss Ashley Stebbins. Among her many favorite memories of Philippine Weekend, Ashley's favorite is undoubtedly her first experience being a part of it. She was first exposed to the cultural dances at a young age and loved making new friends with the kids that she danced with. The best part about being a Philippine Weekend was spending time with her family and friends, where all the dads would go to the park and set up canopies and tents at the far end section so that they'd have a place to relax after performing, or if the weather got too hot to bear. And each family brought all kinds of foods and drinks to share. As kids, Ashley and her sisters, cousins, and friends would wander through the whole park looking at the booths and vendors with different Filipino trinkets and souvenirs and being fascinated by watching the cultural dances. Although there was plenty of food and snacks in her own personal tent, she loved being treated to some Filipino food and snacks sold at the fair. She enjoys these memories because of the joy and comfort it gives her, knowing that although she didn't always see her Filipino family and friends, she could always look forward to seeing them Philippine Weekend to spend time with them again. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Ashley Stebbins. Our next candidate is Miss Maria Taylor. Maria has participated in many Philippine Weekend events over the past 17 years of her life. There's been none that has topped this year's Mr. and Miss Philippine Weekend pageant. She's enjoyed the friendship she's made and being able to see people as who they truly are. Maria says that she will always cherish being a part of the 40th annual Philippine Weekend festivities. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Maria Taylor. Our next candidate is Ms. Emma Anchetta. Ever since Emma was a young girl, she remembers going to Cecil Park on the hottest weekend of July with her family every year. Although she has many great memories of Philippine Weekend, she's also always enjoyed watching the cultural dances. Emma has always been fascinated by the costumes, and all of the beautiful jewelry that the women would wear during their performances. And that is why, Emma says, this is why she was so excited for the native portion of tonight's show. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Emma Anchetta. Miss Candidate is Denica Nabor. Denica's best Philippine Weekend memory is taking a breezy ride on the little blue train around Cecil Park as a child, because she got to wave and smile and then say hi to strangers. She also enjoyed looking at all the different booths and what they had to offer, and all the great events and entertainment that was happening at the park without walking around in the heat. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Denica Nabor. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, your Miss and Mr. Philippine Weekend candidates in formal wear.